देश हमारा है, जन्मभूमि है हमारी शान से कहेंगे हम, सभी तो भाई भाई प्यार से रहेंगे हम, हिंदुस्तानी नाम हमारा है, सबसे प्यारा देश हमारा है।
There is a place for everyone. There is a scope for everyone to encash his own competency, capabilities and talents. But at the end of the day, one should not forget that this world is the hyper-connected world in which we are all a part of it. And to make ourselves most with the identity that we can live the life with full of success in whatever the things that we are going to do on a given day. Work must become learning for
all the people in the organization need to learn
why we are living in that world of complexity and dynamicity. I need to know that my colleague is learning better than me so that I can be better when I'm operating.
To speak about the learning organizations, Peter Senge. What is that learning organization?
Everyone is learning. Learning to excel. Learning to become great. Learning to become a master craftsman.
My dear friend,
your infant speak, but with some kind of a, initially with some kind of a tremor, and it walks, it speaks, it learns, it stands up, it speaks. Who has taught them? The very gene of a human being, love to learn is there. But at the end of the day, let me tell you, there is something like a learning is in me, is in you, is in everybody. And we need to encash that. We need to trigger it. We need to spark it. That could be one of the reasons why even an 80-year-old will be very, very young at heart from Japan is joining an MBA program. Makes a man a sort of a recreation in his thinking, in his approach to life, in his delivery, in his connectedness. Connectedness, what I mean here, quality connections. Today people talk about quality connections. It's not just the connection that I'm going to have here. No, quality connection. Because if I spend 5 minutes with you, and what kind of a difference that you're going to make with your thinking, with the thinking that I have with you in the form of a dialogue that I'm going to have with you for 5 minutes. My entire personality to that extent is going to be reshaped. And that's what exactly I mean, quality connections. It is not simply chat and chat and chat and chat. It's of no use. Continuously. Quality connections are different than simple chatting. In the future, down the line from this day, say after 20 years, after 10 years, after 5 years, because we live with the hope, no human beings, no death is certain to us. We know that death keeps no calendar, but even then we live with the hopes. So obviously our organization should also live with this hope, I mean that kind of a hope. So obviously what the point that I would like to make here is that organizations truly excel in the future. Right? The question is how to tap the talents. We have been a lot of literature on the talents today that people have been talking about. What kind of talents that you are talking about in the context of this kind of a future or this kind of a world that we are confronted with? A special talent, what is that? What is that special talent that can make a quality connections with the people? That can make my energy to be just a flow. Can I talk to the people and they in turn have an interaction with me? So at the end of the day, we make a win-win organization, which is going to be the organization of the future. Organization. Because human beings are so thinkable in nature that if on my own I will slow down, no power of the earth can make me to deliver. Don't talk about the recession.
The organization today is to make a guy to be committed in the job and to see at the end of the day he makes his full potentialities. For that, the organization should provide what is called job clarity. This is very important. Unless I have a clarity about my job as a professor of the institute, I am not going to be committed to the job which you have been talking about. Never ever. I must have a clarity in the job that I am rendering in the organization. Secondly, I must have a control in my job. Very important. Talk about creating and delivering value to all the stakeholders. Talk about the relevant stakeholders. That's meaningful. Committed. Number two, as I said, commitment will also go with the very beautiful thing. I must have a control in my job. And also, I must be 100% clear about my job. That means, if one of the persons in the organization who is my reporting officer will say, don't do that. It's not your job. I have someone else to look into that. Then I feel ashamed. So I am not clear with my job. Then I got to ask with him, tell me, my dear sir, now what is my clarity of the job? What I should do, what I should not do? What I can extend, what I can contract? Tell me, please. So that I can have my performance within the contours of this. Very good. Otherwise, simply you are doing something and there will be restriction for you. That's none of your business to do. There will be some people in the organization who are already deployed for that. You feel ashamed. Clarity. Dawn in my mind. If it is not going to dawn in my mind, at the end of the day, I may not be fitting to that or fitting to this. And people at the end of the day will say, hey, what are you doing here? You're not clear about what you're doing. Clarity is zero here. Something which I'll get back to a bit later. I'm just creating an environment to everybody here. You're all from the industry with lots and lots of background, with experience. So let us create a base for it. Let it trigger in us. So that at the end of the day, I do my job to the best of my satisfaction. And I'm not bothered about what the guys are doing in their own field. Let them do their own work. Let me engage fully into this and let me deliver my best to the people. I think this mindset is very important. Coming back, should I have this feeling? So what I have and what should I have are different. What should I have and what I have are different. Similarly, when we talk about the job, what I am engaged, what I am committed, it has a different connotations, different intensities, different contexts it has. So when we look at certain things, appear to be very simple, we gel with that, we say it is the final one. No, because we can think in different frames, and that frames of thinking is the beauty of the human brain. No other creature on this earth has that beautiful frames of thinking, except the human. Think that, yeah, my job is done. They will never ever get into another mode of learning. So learning is continuous. Learning has no end. Learning has to be made sustainable. And each one should learn from each one. And if that is the concept, what I wish to tell you, an organizing challenge. So learning recreates us. I can recreate myself as this kind of a person with lots and lots of the learning that I'm into, so that I'm going to be a little shaped person at the end of the day, little trimmed, little groomed, little better than what I was